Students, now we shall discuss about the topic, that is double refraction. So the phenomenon of double refraction was discovered by Dr. Erasmus Bartholinus in 1669. The phenomenon of a splitting of a light ray into two refracted rays when it passes through a transparent medium, that is uniaxial or biaxial crystals, known as double refraction phenomena. Once again, the phenomenon of a splitting of a light ray into two refracted rays when it passes through a transparent medium, that is uniaxial or biaxial crystals, known as double refraction phenomena. Now we discuss the double refraction phenomena with the help of calcite crystal. So an ordinary unpolarized, an unpolarized light AB incident on calcite crystal at an angle of incidence I. So inside the calcite crystal, the light ray split into two light rays due to double refraction phenomena. So one light ray which obeys the laws of refraction, but its vibrations parallel to the principal section, known as ordinary ray, while the other ray which doesn't obey the laws of refraction, but its vibration parallel to the principal section of the calcite crystal, that is known as extraordinary ray. So ordinary ray which moves along BD direction, which makes an angle of refraction, that is R1, while the extraordinary ray moves along BC direction, which makes an angle of refraction R2. After emerging from the crystal, both the rays, that is extraordinary ray and ordinary ray, moves parallel to each other. So the two opposite faces of the crystal are parallel to each other. So these two rays, means that is extraordinary ray and ordinary ray, are plane polarized. So this is known as a double refraction phenomena. So according to Snell's law, the refractive indices of ordinary ray and extraordinary ray can be expressed as: the refractive index of ordinary ray is equal to sin I by sin R1, and the refractive index of extraordinary ray is equal to sin I by sin R2. In case of calcite crystal, which is an example of negative crystal, the refractive index of ordinary ray always greater than the refractive index of extraordinary ray, because the angle of refraction of ordinary ray always less than the angle of refraction of extraordinary ray, or the velocity of ordinary ray always less than the velocity of extraordinary ray in case of calcite crystal. So because mu naught greater than mu means the refractive index is equal to the velocity of light in vacuum by the velocity of light in medium. So from this we conclude that the refractive index is inversely proportional to velocity of light in medium. So that's why here the refractive index of ordinary ray always greater than the refractive index of extraordinary ray. So in case of positive crystals, the refractive index of ordinary ray always less than the refractive index of extraordinary ray, because the velocity of ordinary ray greater than the velocity of extraordinary ray. The examples of positive crystals are quartz and ferric oxide. So V naught is the velocity of ordinary ray, V is the velocity of extraordinary ray. So in case of calcite crystal, the refractive index of ordinary ray is same for all angle of incidence, while the refractive index of extraordinary ray varies with the angle of incidence. So therefore, the velocity of ordinary ray moves in all directions, but the extraordinary ray moves in different direction with different speeds. So ordinary ray moves with same speed in all directions. So that is the reason. So in case of calcite crystals, so this is the phenomenon about double refraction phenomena. Now one example explained with. So now keep a dot on white paper. the calcite crystal is keep over the or that see through the calcite crystal, then two images appears. Now the crystal is rotated over the paper. That one image is stationary while the other image is rotate in the direction of rotation of calcite crystal. So the stationary image appears bright. It is known as ordinary ray, while the other meets that is rotator image appears more bright. That is known as extraordinary ray. So in this case also double refraction phenomena occurs. So thank you students. Now see the answer from starting to ending.